Hey there! You're one of the students here at the Academy, aren't you?
Or Berna. Presumably, one of the instructors. Asking if it's Lilly. I'm Berna, an instructor here at the Academy. Asking if there's anything she can do for Lilly. Of course, I'd like to ask how serious this plague might really be. We instructors are here to give guidance to the students. How else will you complete your training? Well, Berna's mistaken. Well, he's not a student. She's training to be an instructor. Asking about the Wailing Death. I know the quarantine of the city has done little to stop the affliction from spreading, though it has bred mistrust and fear among the people. Lady Arbeth does her best to keep the peace, but the rumors are beginning to fly. People suspect some dark evil is behind the Wailing Death. Soon the panic may lead to open rebellion. I pray we of the Academy are not forced into battle against the citizens of Neverwinter. They are the very people we're supposed to protect. I think Lily's curious what it's like to work under Lady Arbeth. Lady Arbeth Deltilmarand is a paladin of Tyr. She may be young, but she's already proven her courage and her devotion to both Neverwinter and Tyr. Lord Nashor Alagander himself has given Lady Arbeth the task of saving Neverwinter from the Wailing Death. She's actually here, at the Academy right now, in the South Assembly Hall. Once you've finished your training, you can go meet her. Yeah, where would Lily do that? Just head through the exit in the southwest corner of this room. It's an odd way to put it. The Academy training rooms are all in the hallway beyond. Once you finish your training, you can go meet Arbeth in the South Assembly Hall. Alright. Goodbye, Lily. Berna's talk of the plague is quite distressing. Lily just hopes it isn't going to interfere with her appointment as a mistress of the Arcane. One last look through the library before all its precious collections are turned to smoldering ash by Olgerd's Red Ring. Lily imagines she'll have to assign books for her students to read outside of lectures. If so, what could be better than to assign a text she's written herself? The Academy would no doubt consider itself lucky to have the honor of publishing her very first work. She tries to imagine what she might call it. Black on Black Arts, Lily's Guide to the Arcane. It could be followed by Black on White, Lily's Guide to the Rest, the following year, or something like that. Then, in the third year, maybe a bit of fun. She could publish a multi-volume series on footwear, Black on Boots. After the success of her first two published works, the Academy certainly wouldn't care what she wrote about, as long as she bestowed wisdom about something. Lily needs to finish her instructor training, but she's not sure where.
It's about time you showed up, recruit. My name is Herban. As far as your wild tide is concerned, you can just call me sir.
It's my job to teach you raw recruits some tips on combat techniques so you maggots don't get gutted out there in the real world. Well, recruit, don't just stand there with that dopey expression on your face. What's it going to be? Are you ready to begin your combat training or aren't you? I think Lily doesn't understand why he has to shout and put on such a show. You address me as sir when you open your mouth, maggot. If this plague hadn't made us so desperate for recruits, I'd boot your worthless ass out of here for that type of attitude. Alright, Lily's had enough of this conversation. If Lily ever finds herself back in Durhamore with Crispy, she'll be sure to commission a pair of boots to be made from none other than Herban's own detestable hide. In fact, she imagines she'd look quite sensuous in her Herban thigh highs.
Hello there.
Oh, this is Ferdinand. You must be Lily Black, the one I've heard all the instructors talking about. They're mighty impressed with you, I must say. It's a pleasure to finally meet you, Lily. I'm Ferdinand, the Academy's resident keeper of exotic creatures. I was afraid you wouldn't make it by my little quarter before you completed your training here at the Academy. So, have you come here to view the menagerie? Or is there something else I could do for you? Yeah, she's not sure what he's talking about. This academy was founded with the purpose of training adventurers, so it only makes sense that we would collect stranger and exotic monsters, the kind adventurers might encounter during their explorations. We allow our students to study the creatures and their habits up close, so they'll better be prepared when they encounter such beasts in the wild. I think Lily's curious what they might be learning through experiments. Hey, we're not savages. The animals are here for us to observe, not to butcher. Every month, Yusam, the local druid, comes by to inspect the creatures and make sure they're treated right. And I'm always watching for signs of injury or illness. Every one of my animals is well fed and properly cared for. I look after my charges. I'm like their father. Yeah, I think Lily's just curious what they were learning. Just not concerned for the animals' welfare. I think she is curious to see them. Certainly. As long as you're here at the academy, you're free to view the menagerie anytime you want. Don't worry. The monsters in there can't hurt you. We've taken every precaution, including powerful spells of binding, to make the menagerie completely safe for both visitors and the creatures inside. Just head on through the door here whenever you're ready to view the wonders of my little beasties. Lily must have been mistaken. She thought this was an institution of higher learning that encouraged the pursuit of knowledge, not animal companionship. No matter. Lily takes a tour of Ferdinand's little beasties. The giant stag beetle. Serious pests that can strip an entire farm's cultivated crops in short order, with adults reaching as long as 10 feet. Lily wonders what has been eating with those huge horn-like mandibles. Of course, Lily's no stranger to Ettercaps, having still vivid memories of them from Cloakwood. They're fond of spiders and often keep them as pets. Lily wonders if they eat them, too. The Hook Horror, an underground dwelling creature with an insect-like exoskeleton, a vulture-like head, and completely useless hooks for hands, thought to be a distant relative of the cockroach. Lily can't imagine having to pick everything up with her mouth. Horrible indeed. Lily's no stranger to the Umber Hulk either. In fact, she's had quite enough of them after her forays into the Underdark. 800 pounds of vicious ape and beetle. Its twitching mandibles and rows of triangular teeth are making Lily nervous. A dire spider? Lily wonders if it belongs to the Ettercap. Dire. A dire creature is simply a larger, tougher, meaner version of a normal one, typically having a feral or prehistoric look. If Lily were to teach that term in a lecture, she'd only have to point to Herban, a dire human, right here in the academy, pretending to be a member of the faculty. Lily could collect a menagerie of her own, of men.
Nobody walks away!
Put them in cages. Short fat ones, tall lanky ones, young, old, yet all equally despicable.
You need to speak to Herban first. He's in charge here.
You and me!
Lily is certainly not going to speak to Sir Dire. She will help herself to some archery equipment, though. She tries to decide between the long and short bow. She's had little experience with either, except the tiny bit Hull insisted on back at Candlekeep when she was younger. She decides on the short bow simply for its lighter weight. Not to mention, the long bow is almost as tall as her.
Evil shall never triumph!
All before me!
After her first year of instructorship, Lily will have to start a new tradition here at the academy, an end-of-the-year competition of sorts between the various schools, in particular to give hers, the Arcane, a chance to prove not only the quality of her leadership, but the superiority of students of the art against the likes of Sir Dire, and the baboons with weapons he fancies students. Lily hopes that the combat training area, including everything and everyone in it, is the first to go in Olgerd's glorious fire. Arcane magic training with instructor Jaroo. No wonder they invited Lily to replace him. Nobody could be more incompetent, less intelligent, or worse for the position, except Zedir, of course. He's probably the one who had the academy issue uniforms in purple. Lily's not surprised to see that he's wearing olive trim either.
Hey there. Welcome to my little corner of the academy. I'm Jaroo, resident master of the Arcane. It's more a ceremonial title than anything else. I'm really just your run-of-the-mill wizard.
No doubt you've come here to complete your training. Well, you've come to the right place. Nobody at this institution knows more about teaching you apprentices magic than me. Consider this a final tutorial on casting spells before you face the Mage's Challenge. Asking Lily if she's ready to begin. Tutorial? Lily needs no tutorial. Really? Well, if you're ready, then I guess we can begin. The test is a simple one, Lily. See the statue in the center of the room? Presumably, this one. All you have to do is destroy it using a spell, and the challenge will be complete. To help you in this task, there are two scrolls in the chest against the north wall. You can scribe these scrolls to your spellbook, or use them directly. Come speak to me when you finish the test. I'll be waiting right here. This is the final challenge. Destroy a statue and given two scrolls with which to do it? Too easy. Melf's acid arrow. Only 159 more to go. But Lily is privately nervous. What if something goes wrong? How embarrassing would that be? She better make sure Chandra, a student currently practicing here with Zedir, is willing to help out, just in case. Lily hopes to find some more scrolls by his books in the corner. Any she would find would obviously be beyond the understanding of his tiny little mind anyway. But she only finds a book on history. She should have known he wasn't studying anything relevant to the Arcane. Lily's glad to see that Chandra's well-rounded enough to take an interest in things outside the Arcane. A book on Uthgardt tribes. Lily recalls that Faldorn was from the Black Raven tribe. Oh, that explained her manners, or lack thereof, at least. Lily examines Chandra's clothes and notices they're neither red nor fire-resistant.
Well, hello to you.
Oh, of course, this is Chandra. Asking if it really is Lily. We were in the same arcane theory class, I believe. My name is Chandra.
Ortano, for Digyama!
I've heard your study here at the academy is almost complete, Lily. Must be looking forward to graduating. Well, she's at least looking forward to her appointment. I envy you. I hear Lady Arabeth herself is here to hand out personal blessings. I hope she returns for my own graduation. I'd love to meet her. I don't think Lily's surprised to hear that Chandra would like to meet Lady Arabeth. She's curious how her training's going. I could ask for no finer instructor than Jaroo. He's both patient and well-versed in the arcane arts. To be sure, the lessons are difficult and the workload is often great. I've spent many nights burning countless candles as I study my tomes. But success comes to those who persevere. One need only look to Lady Arabeth to see a shiny example of that. I do hope I get a chance to meet her before she leaves. Yeah, thought we just asked that. Work is difficult, but Jaroo is quick to aid any who stumble in their pursuit of the ancient knowledge. Yeah, I think Lily's curious what Chandra knows about the plague. I know little enough about it. My family were nobles in the Black Lake District, and the Wailing Death has yet to touch that section of the city. Of course, that's good to know. I do know that there are those who blame the plague on foul necromancy, even here in the Academy. Their eyes burn with hatred whenever they look upon my mage's cloak. Doesn't sound good for Lilly, then. Perhaps they're right in their suspicions of the plague's origins, but it's not right to blame old wizards. They judge us when they don't even know us. I'll resume my studies then. Apparently, she's been left out of the conspiracy. A pity. She'll be missed. Lilly thought she was cute, too. Well, for a half-elf at least. The mage's challenge. Lilly casts magic missile from a scroll, wondering if she could hit Zedir and make it look like an accident.
Great control of your magical abilities. Speak to me before you leave. Your training is done. You should go to the South Assembly Hall to receive a blessing and congratulations from Lady Arabeth.
But before you go, please accept this gift as a reward for completing your training. Good luck to you, Lilly. I don't know what your future holds, but I sense you're destined for great things. Yeah, Rot of Frost, and again, as always, unlimited uses per day is awfully useful, especially for a mage to fall back on. Although grateful for the Rod of Frost, she can't help but be bothered to own or imagine herself depending on something crafted by Jaroo. As she learns Melf's acid arrow, she imagines how she would do things differently. When she's Mistress of the Arcane, she'll hand out something even better, like Boots of the Winterlands. Yes, perfect for anyone this far north. Take Chandra, for example. Not only would the thick furry boots look good on her, they'd prevent her from slipping on the ice, and keep her toes warm too, as if wrapped in an Endure Elements versus Cold spell. As an added benefit, the boots don't leave tracks in the snow either, for anyone who likes a bit of mischief once in a while. A splendid gift indeed. Not some boring rod that delivers frost when you're already stuck in the brisk jewel of the north. Lilly can't wait to initiate all these changes her first year as a new instructor.